It does not matter where you are right now or who you have been. If you have faith and a relentless desire to succeed, you can really achieve anything in this world. Have faith, you will be great, and go get it.
Hi everyone, and welcome to Superb Circuits 2. Thanks for joining us. Please make sure you warm up before every video. We don't always include a warm up. And please read the disclaimer at the beginning. This workout requires no equipment, and we're going to be doing two sets, 50 seconds, 10 seconds rest, with five exercises. If you're ready, let's begin. First exercise is no rope skip. Some people call this imaginary skipping. Okay, I think it's skipping with no rope. Anyway, bouncing on the feet, keeping the knees soft, ankles soft, and back straight and head up. Imagine you are skipping with a real rope. This can be a real space saver, and of course, if you don't have a skipping rope, well, this one helps too. If you've ever wanted to get good at skipping, this is a good exercise to do to build yourself up to the coordination and, of course, have the minor jumping ability or that little spring in the step. So bouncing from foot to foot, keep the knees soft, back straight, head up, and spin the wrists as if you're actually spinning a real rope. Coordinate the hands with the feet and make sure you're leaving the ground by at least an inch to let that imaginary rope under. Rest. Good job, everybody. Okay, next exercise is a squat with a floor touch. Great exercise. Begin. Okay, so we've got a square feet. You can do a wide or a short stance. And we're keeping the back straight and the head up, but we're reaching down and touching just the fingertips to the floor. This helps to make sure that you are squatting deep enough on every squat. A lot of the time when we do squats, we can't always gauge that our squat is deep enough. So this is a great way to check that you're actually going deep enough. Make sure you keep your head up, your back straight, and stick your butt out. We don't want the knees coming forward over the toes. Feet square, butt back, back straight, head up, and touching the floor with just the fingertips. Keep that motion going. We're doing these quite quick today. We want to get quite an aerobic side up. Squat down, nice and deep, get that butt down. And rest, 10 seconds rest. Take those feet double shoulder width for a side to side lunge now. Here we go. So we're gonna do a variation one, very similar to the previous exercise. Side to side lunge with a floor touch, with a floor touch. So our feet are square, toes facing forwards, and we wanna drop to one side. The bent leg is in the same as the previous squat position, and the straight leg is obviously straight. There we go, okay? You can tell I can't script these beforehand. Anyway, feet square, dropping from one side to the other. Make sure your technique is nice and clean. We're doing these quite quickly right now, but obviously if you need to, slow them right down, get that technique right, and you're trying to touch the floor about 6 inches from the foot that you are leaning towards, okay? Very good. Okay, I think I've just said to Nat there to slow down a little bit. Okay, I'm getting old, just turned 40, so need to go a little bit slower, okay? 3 seconds, the next exercise, down to the floor. Here we go, guys, with one of the favorites, mountain climbers. Alternating leg, mountain climber sprint, these are. All right, heads up, back straight. And you wanna be sprinting the knee up to the chest. The front foot, the bent leg, does not touch the ground. Your hands are either side of your chest. Make sure your chin is above your fingers. So that chin is above your fingers. So if you're finding yourself dropping behind your hands, then you're risking a shoulder injury. So keep that nice push-up position and sprinting those legs in, knee to chest. I know these ones aren't easy, guys. Definitely a good bit of advice with this one is just try and keep going as long as you can and try to go as fast as you can to start with. You will slow down. That's great. I don't always find that one easy myself, being a big 200 guy. So it's a good exercise to do. Next exercise is forward and back plank. So forearm plank. Okay. Sorry about dropping out a shot there, guys, but forearm plank on the forearms, elbows under the shoulders, and we are rocking back and forth with the shoulders and the toes, taking ourselves towards the front hand and then driving back up to the forearm plank position. Heads up, belly button sucked in, back straight, and just moving as much as you can, okay? You see I'm starting to struggle with this one there. See, we all struggle. If you can't keep moving backwards and forwards, just hold the forearm plank. There's nothing wrong with going back to the basic. How do you take an advanced and turn it back to a basic? You work out what the original exercise was and take out the change. So forward and back plank is forearm plank. On your backs, guys, for basic crunch. And there's not much more basic abdominal exercise than the basic crunch. So, feet flat on the floor, legs at 90 degrees, and fingers on your temples, and I want you to keep your chin off your chest. If you look at my chin there, you can see it cleanly off my chest, lifting the shoulder blades off the ground, and just working those top four upper abdominal muscles. Okay, guys? Lift the chin, lift the shoulders, get the shoulder blades off the floor, squeeze, and then lower back down. Keep those feet flat on the floor. Really try to get those shoulders off the ground. Keep it going, guys, you're doing great. 3, 2, 1, great job. Okay, get yourselves a 10 second rest. And up we get, because we're going back to the start for round two. Here we go, guys. Second and final round. Okay, I like doing these kind of workouts. These are really good combined with some of the other videos. Feel free to check out the other videos. Keeping light on the toes, this is a really good workout to do. As if you're a bit more advanced, perhaps as a basic warm-up. Okay, I'm doing some high knee sprints there. Okay, you can really mess around with this one, have a lot of fun with it, do some crossovers. It looks a little wild without the rope. But that is what you can do with a real rope. You can do some high knee runs, some crossovers, some big jumps, whatever you want to do. Even if you're a very good skipper, this is still a good exercise, especially if you don't have a rope with you. And rest. Nice job, guys. Nice job. Okay, and that's very focused there. It's very focused. All right, 3 seconds. Squat down, touch the floor. There we go. There's a smile. Good job. Feet square. Get that butt down. Touch the floor. Right in the middle, fingertips only, back straight, head up, stick that butt out each time. Good job, feet square, sitting down each time. Lovely technique from that there. If you watch Nat for that form, that's really good. Okay, the butt's going back, toes facing forward, back straight, head up. Good, we got 15 seconds left, keep it going. Back straight, head up, touching the floor each time. Turn it sideways there so you can see the technique, see my knees. The knees do go forwards, but they don't go forwards of the toes. Butt back each time. And relax. Good. Always remember, guys, you can always go slower than we are. You do not have to go as fast. Side to side lunge with a floor touch. Here we go. Back straight, head up. Stick your butt out so that you can reach the floor, okay? Don't bend your back. Sit your butt back so you can reach the floor. Really try and go to the side first before you lean over to touch the floor. To the side and then reach down. You want to reach about 6 inches from your foot each time. Remember, not too fast with these. Get that form right. Nice stretch in the inside leg, the adductor. You're squatting with one leg and doing a split with the other leg. Just go as far as you can. Get that butt down. This is a glutes and inside leg exercise. So you want to be concentrating your glutes, driving you up every time. Good. Catch your breath. 10 seconds. Doing great. Down the floor, guys. For mountain climbers. Off we go. Back straight, head up, alternating knee to chest. Okay, make sure you keep your heads up so your spine is in line. You will need to be slightly outside of PUP position, push-up position, position. Oh, push-up position, position. Put my teeth in before I start this, maybe next time. And the hands are either side of the shoulders. Keep that chin above the fingers. So you don't want those hands above your head. Very important, that one, okay? Keep it going. And as I said earlier, you know, if you're not very good at this one, really just really try and push yourself with it every time and keep the speed. Don't go too slowly, okay? This is a cardio exercise, not a core exercise done like this. That's great. All right, get that 10-second rest in. And we've got our forward and back plank now. Let's go. Plank position, butt down, head up. And we're going forwards and back. And in this second round, you can clearly see the exercise a lot better, okay? Better angle there. Or it was a better angle, then I decided to change it back to here. I think because Nat's decided to take over the whole room. I don't quite have enough room, so. Okay? It's not like she can take up as much room as I can. So, forwards and back. Rolling over the toes. You can see on my back foot there, rolling over the toe and then driving back, keeping your core tight and your back straight. We got 10 seconds left. Yes, you can do it. Let's go, guys. Okay, Nat's going a little quicker there. If you want to go a little quicker, you can do. Keep your back straight and your head up. And rest. Final exercise, basic crunch, guys. Everybody doing great? Good. On your backs. And basic crunch. Here we go. Feet shoulder width apart, legs at 90 degrees. Fingers on temples, crunch up. Keep your chin off your chest. That's good. All right. Want to take this opportunity for a quick shout out to all of my clients, but a particular shout out to Nat. We've been talking about her a lot recently. She's just finished her second UK BFF bikini competition, of which she brought home a trophy. We have a champion in our midst. And she's worked extremely hard, okay, guys? You can all achieve great results if you have a deadline. So that is the tip for the day. Give yourself a goal, give yourself a deadline, and then make sure to focus until you achieve that deadline, which is just what she did. UK BFF champion. Well done, Matt.